Alright, so give me a second. There is apparently something I missed. I wish there was just a way I could skip the entire cutscene. There's supposed to be a guy here, isn't there? Correctly identify Teru Adachi as the culprit. Max out Mari's social link. Clear out the Hollow Forest secret dungeon during the ski trip. We'll be able to unlock the true final boss. Once you've talked to everyone, prompt you and ask if you'd like to stay. Go home. Say no until you get the opportunity to continue exploring. Oh, right. Okay, so I have to go to Juness first. The usual food court. It's where you had spent so many afternoons going over the case with everyone. Just sitting here brings back a lot of memories.
Huh? What a coincidence! It must be destiny!
Oh, so you guys came here too!
It's our very own special headquarters. There are so many memories here.
Yo there, Senpai. I thought you'd be here.
We had a feeling we'd run into everyone if we came here.
We were planning on seeing you off at the station tomorrow, but I was feeling too restless, so I decided to come here.
Aw, look at that.
Well, since we're all here, why don't we have something to eat?
Ooh, let's have steak! Steak! And make Yosuke pay for everything!
Why?
Will you shut up about your steaks?
I want steak now. You reminisced with the others.
I really had fun in this world.
Dude, your whole existence is about fun. Well, what we've gone through wasn't all fun and games. But I gotta say, I've never felt so fulfilled in my life.
It seems we've been working on this forever, but at the same time, it felt like it went so fast.
Fuck, I feel ya, dude.
We won't ever gather here again like this, or tear our hair out trying to solve the mysteries.
Even if we wanted to talk about it all, there were so many extraordinary things that no one would believe us. Come to think of it, for me, I think it all started when Chie told me about the Midnight Channel.
I think I heard about it from her, too.
Mm-hmm.
How did you learn about it, Chie?
I guess it was just a random rumor. A lot of girls were trying it out.
Huh. I wonder how it started, then.
Who knows? Maybe someone accidentally came across it?
The Midnight Channel. You know, that really was the cause of everything.
I know, right?
I mean, the fog lifted after we caught Adachi, but there's still a lot of stuff that isn't clear yet. It's still foggy over there, too.
Some weird guy might use it to do bad things again.
Pretty much.
Didn't that Amino something monster say it granted us power?
I bestowed power onto those who could brave the Hollow Forest. In other words, he gave the power to enter TVs to those who awakened to their persona ability, so that he might use us as pawns to enact his scheme.
Hey, that reminds me. Didn't your hand suddenly slip into the TV even before anything happened to you? Does that mean you're an exception? Well, wait, then what about Adachi and Namatame? Those two could go inside TVs before all this stuff about personas, right?
Mm-hmm.
What? Then Senpai and the other two could do it for some other reason?
Then there must be something you're not remembering. Anything come to your mind, Senpai?
You're the only exception. You had the power to enter TVs before your persona awakened. The same goes for Adachi and Namatame. Ronika gave you something this morning as you were about to leave.
A letter? Hey, this better not be another warning.
The sender is listed as Adachi?
Huh? This is from jail? It's from Adachi.
It's from Adachi!
I'm sure you're surprised to get this letter out of the blue. I'm writing this because there's something I need to tell you. Ever since I made it out alive, there are some things I understand now. It's true that my game's over. As you all insisted at the time, I'll abide by the rules of this world. But as long as I'm in stir here, I can't clean up after myself. So I hope this will give you something to think about regarding this case. There's still this feeling I can't shake. It's about how it all started, about that midnight channel. Now I remember, someone told me about it when I first came to town, before I heard the rumors at the station. And I was intrigued when I noticed that something similar was written on Namatame's reports as well. But I can't remember who it was that told me. Since Namatame and I both gained our power after coming to Inaba, I have a feeling that has something to do with it. I don't know if any of this will be useful or not. But I hope it can help somehow.
Not very helpful to know that he can't remember who it was.
But it helps that we remember somebody was there.
I'm not sure how to put it, but I kind of know the feeling. It's like, I don't know how to say this. Like something's connecting all these things. Something beyond what we can see.
Yeah, I had that feeling too when I went forward in time and saw the game over and thought, wait, that can't be it.
That world, the midnight channel, the ability to enter TVs, they all feel like separate things. You know what I mean? First the rumors, then the serial murder, followed by us deciding to investigate the case.
Mm-hmm.
If they all really were separate, they wouldn't fit together like this, right?
Right.
There has to be some kind of conductor behind everything.
So you think the person Adachi mentioned, the one who told him about the Midnight Channel, is that conductor? Did I strike gold again? It's seriously just something that popped into my head!
Senpai, is there anything like that you can think of?
Power to enter TV is where everything in this about this case started. I learned about the Midnight Channel from Shie a few days after coming to this town when she told you the rumor. But Adachi and Namatame heard about the Midnight Channel from someone immediately after coming to this town. Think back, you feel as though it was something happened to you well upon your arrival here. Right, I met Mary! Didn't I meet Mary the moment I came in, like... walked into town?
We were involved in a murder case last year, which we succeeded in solving. But the monster we fought last said we did well in playing our parts.
Mm-hmm.
Perhaps this means Adachi and Namatame were players as well.
Huh.
Could it be that from the beginning, this serial murder case was merely a portion of a much larger scheme? And none of the people who were directly involved in the case ever suspected it.
Well, it is something that happened. I met Mary, right?
Hey, this scheme. Could it be the whole thing about filling both worlds with the fog and turning mankind into shadows? So someone was behind the scenes watching us. The culprits. And maybe even that monster. And he manipulated Adachi and Namatame at the very beginning, so everything would come together perfectly?
Huh. Let's go out into town. We might find something. Although, you may be the only one capable of noticing it. Please contact the rest of us should you come across anything.
We can't say our goodbyes tomorrow with this hanging over our heads. Let's go figure this out.
Hell yeah. The initial spark. It was Dojima first, and then Nanako, who was hiding behind him. But at the very least, there was somebody... The only other person I met immediately was Mary. But I guess immediate is subject to... You know... Change. You behind all this? I like being able to harass random people. Doesn't seem to know anything. What's up, gamers? Interesting. Oh, nice. So I need to find Nanako and Dojima. Dojima is the killer! I knew it. Hey, buddy.
Hmm? Did you already meet all your friends? Today you first came to town? Let's see. We were the first ones to greet you, right?
Sarasith, apparently, according to my sister, Sapara, there, I did not get the true ending. Yeah, that. So I came back to look at it.
Did we stop somewhere on the way home? I'm pretty sure Nanako and I left home that afternoon, picked you up, and came straight back.
Wait, we didn't come straight back. We went to the gas station, didn't we?
Now that I think back to that night, I was called back to work as soon as we got home, so I couldn't talk much. And the very next day, those strange murders started. Sheesh. Lots happened since then. It's been one heck of a year, hasn't it?
Hey, big bro. On the first day, didn't we stop at that place? The gas station. I used the bathroom there.
Right. And the gas station... and the gas station attendant wouldn't shut the fuck up about literally whatever the hell he was talking about.
When I got back to the car, you were talking to the weird attendant.
Yeah, the attendant?
Yeah, when I first met you, I remembered the gas attendant because he was weird.
Now that you mention it, I do remember that. I filled the tank before you went home, huh? I do remember you talking to the attendant there. I didn't remember seeing him much before, so he stuck in my mind.
Yeah, the fucking weirdo.
But I don't know about calling him weird. It wasn't like he looked or acted funny. Yeah. Come to think of it, I never saw that guy again.
Really? Are you sure? I saw that guy a lot. He was there, like, every other time I went to the fucking place.
It wasn't really that the attendant looked weird.
Yeah, I saw him multiple times.
But after you talked to him, you looked sick, big bro.
Did I? I look sick?
Don't you remember? I asked you on the way home. Are you car sick? You said you were okay, but... that attendant, he was just a little scary for some reason.
Okay, can the two of you not tag team me like this?
Well, I didn't know about that. But honestly, I'm surprised you're asking all these questions. I thought you came here just to reminisce. So, why are you looking for the person you met first? Is something going on with that attendant? Do you know him?
It might be important. I see.
Well, just remember that you leave tomorrow. I don't know what you're up to, but you should come back home early.
We're trying.
There are some dark clouds on the horizon. We might get some rain soon.
Wait for me.
Okay.
See, that's where I went first because I remember stopping at the gas station. And I do remember talking to that weirdo who just wouldn't shut the fuck up. It was almost like he refused to do his job. Only an older man and woman working there? What? Where do I go from here, then? Wait, what?
Welcome to the Velvet Room. How may I help you? You have solved the mystery and deflected the disaster that so nearly fell upon you.
What?
Is there something else beyond this you need our assistance with?
One last thing.
Intriguing. So, is there still something that leaves you unsatisfied?
Yeah.
What may that be?
Why do you keep asking me if I regret anything?
Well then, let's take a look and see what it is you might be sensing.
Are we still moving?
Wow. That's a lot.
Ah, this is a surprise. These are shards of power, allowing one to see through to the truth of things without being swayed by hollow rumors.
Is this limo still moving?
Interesting. Indeed, you have come here today for a reason.
Why are you asking if I'm dreaming?
Then I shall play my part as well. That is a crystal of power, which you have nurtured through your journey.
It's fucking big.
An orb that repels fabrications of all sorts, dispels lies, and shines upon the truth.
Orb of sight.
Hey, I remembered something about myself. I was born a long, long time ago. I was the unconscious wish shared by people's minds to protect the world of man, walk the path of man, fulfill the wish of the world. That was my role.
Fucking what? I thought your role was to fucking disappear.
But
people change.
People stopped wishing for truth in life. Or maybe they just stopped paying attention. Eventually, the me that wanted to protect humanity and the me that wanted to fulfill humanity's wish couldn't stay as one. The desires of man had no bounds, and one day, my other half became its own existence, much larger than myself. I was left behind, with no power or memories.
What do you mean, no power? You fucking no-sailed everything we did to you at one point.
I became a tiny fragment, incapable of even clearing the fog without giving my own life to do so. Kusumi no Okami. The rest, you already know. Without my powers, I became a tool, manipulated by the other me. You already know, huh? The cause of it all. The one who created the Midnight Channel and gave you the power to enter the TV. The real Puppet Master, who tried to fill both worlds with fog, using me and the Sagiri. If you don't defeat her, the world will never be truly clear of that fog. Go. Follow what you believe in. The truth is right in front of you.
Truth is a thing which only appears to those who have observed, considered, and made a choice. At the end of the path you chose lies the truth. Believe in it, and continue without faltering.
How marvelous.
What the fuck is happening?
It seems that you will reveal the journey's true end, one beyond our predictive power. Now go to the place where everything began.
Sorry, there was something on my monitor. Began raining. There's that gas station attendant. Oh, it started raining. I don't have an umbrella, dang it. Sarasith, are you here? Because I feel like, for some reason, you're going to want to stay and watch this. Hi there, do you need something? Isn't this where I first, what are you talking about? Oh, is this about the part-time job? I'm sorry, we don't have an opening yet. Do you know what got you? Real tragedy, wasn't it? But the case was solved, right? Thank goodness. Have you met those two? That's a weird question to ask. I don't know if it was right here, but I might have met them before. I've been in this town for a long time, so yeah, that's a good chance. It's not like I knew them personally. Have you been in this town? Mind leaving me alone? Oh, you still need something? Hey, I asked you to leave me alone. Did you miss that? Did you do anything to them? Huh? To those two? Ah, that's right. I remember now. I think I met them when they first came to town. So I greeted them, saying, "Welcome to Inaba." But that's all. Just that. What about it? What did you do to me? What did I do? Don't you remember? I met you here when you first came to town and did the same thing as to what I did to those two. Greeted you, that's all, remember? We talked for a couple minutes. Hey, mind if I ask you something? Why all these questions? Is there something that's bothering you about the time when we first met? Yes, there is. Amazing. You've reached me at last. Let's drop this charade. To be quite honest, I was waiting for you to come. Adachi, Nawatame, and you. It is I who awakened that power within you three. The ones who had potential. But having said that, I'm rather surprised.
You really are troublesome. Not only did you defeat the two Sagiri I snuck into Adachi and Namatame, but you even saved that stunted dwarf of a life.
Talking about Mary?
It's such a foolish thing. What good is saving her life?
Wait a minute. You were that other voice with Mary, weren't you?
She is but rubbish. Suitable only for getting rid of that pointless fog. Hmm?
Don't tell me she was still carrying that around. Oh, excuse me. I was talking about that bamboo comb you have on you.
Why do you laugh?
I apologize, but the appropriateness was just so amusing.
The comb is a symbol of the separation we went through.
What, Phantom? What, Sapara? Remember that Kanji's mother mentioned that when you visited Tatsumi Textiles, Mary. It's an old belief that combs have the power to cause separation.
How foolish. That comb was a curse. And to think she treasured it all this time. She must have been desperate for something to cling to. There's a limit to how irresponsible you can get.
You're clearly a woman. I assume. How did people mistake you for a male attendant? In Japan. You've messed with me as well.
And what are you going to do about it? The last battle wasn't enough for you. You certainly have the powers I was expecting.
Yeah? Who the fuck are you?
You must know by now. Isn't that why you came? Your friends were drawn to the spark I stirred in you. That's why they're here now, with their awakened powers. Still, I didn't think you'd make it all the way to me. Indeed, I never expected this at all. You're really something. What? You don't remember?
I'm gonna fucking punch
you. When you first came to town, I gave your power a gentle push.
Yeah?
Just like this.
Jesus.
Are you in high school? Does it surprise a city boy to see how little there is out here? There's so little to do, I'm sure you'll get bored fast. You'll either be hanging out with your friends or doing part-time jobs. Speaking of which, we're actually looking for part-time help right now. Give it some thought, why don't you? We don't mind if you're a student.
Was this voice acted earlier? Felt an extreme dizziness.
You're not the only one I welcomed to town with a handshake greeting. I did the same for a few other outsiders like you. A handful of strangers were more than sufficient to stimulate a small place like this.
Yeah?
But it seems the stimulus was stronger than I imagined. Enough to envelop this town with fog, and later lift it.
There's fog right now. What are you doing?
Not only that, you now stand before me as if your assigned part wasn't enough. What for?
Yeah? What for, huh? Great. I love these choices. What is this all for, huh? I want to know the truth of what the fuck you're doing here.
What will grasping the truth do for you? Why such greed? I guess it's the foolish nature of being mortal.
Wait a minute.
I am Izanami.
Wait. Izanami.
Amano Sagiri, ruler of the fog, is merely an aspect of myself that I birthed long ago. You awakened to a power I had not imagined. You defeated the two Sagiri and the one fragment born from me. And now here you stand, face to face with me. I can no longer ignore this situation as mere foolishness. This may be fate, as decreed by the world.
Sarasith, this is the mother of gods, apparently.
Very well. This time I shall pit my full strength against you.
Sorry, excuse me.
But in return, you must come prepared to follow through in your futile resistance. I'll be waiting for you there.
Wait, weren't you the wife of Izanagi? Her name is Izanagi. Friend's voice is in the distance.
Hey, are you alright? Who was that you were just talking to?
God.
Did she just disappear?
Well, yeah, she's God.
Wait, don't tell me.
She's God? You told your friends, your gathered friends, that God appeared before you. And it's a fucking asshole.
So, it wasn't over after all.
No.
You're saying this so-called Izanami is the conductor, and she's waiting for us in the other world?
Yeah.
If we don't beat her, I'm sure it'll all happen again.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. The others aren't far off, so I'll call them up.
Yeah, will ya? Tell them this is really gonna close the case.
Right. We'll defeat her and put an end to this for sure this time.
Fuck.
All right. Then once we're all ready, let's meet up at Juness.
Cause of everything. If Izanami truly gave birth to Amano Sugiri, then as long as she's left alone, the Tau will definitely pull into fog again someday. Most important task. God, I've gotten two bad endings in this game already. And on top of that, I can barely beat this game, Amano Sugiri on normal difficulty. Like, I fucked, like, I had to go back, right, after I learned, shut up, Phantom. I had to go back after I learned that I lost the footage between myself and Amano Sugiri. And I couldn't even beat him on normal. Yes! Yes! I regret everything! God damn, shut up, all of you!
Thank you for your time. If you enjoyed yourself, please like and subscribe.